Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video we are going to talk about a recent launch of Realme. Realme's launch, which happened just today, that is 25th of May. So it happened at live in China as well as in India simultaneously, where Realme launched mini products like a smartwatch, TV, earbuds, all those stuffs, power bank and so, but we can't discuss everything in a single video. So in this video we're going to talk about a new phone which has been launched by Realme. So that is Realme X50 Pro Player Edition. So in the sense, this phone is basically for gamers who's interested around the world, and it is also a budget friendly phone as well. So the first thing which we are going to talk here in this phone is basically about its primary specs. So primary specs in this sense, if there are some people who have no idea about phones, but still they look on these basic specs and they just buy phones in maybe in online or in from stores and so. For those people, this phone comes with 6.44 inches. It comes with 4200 mAh, 6GB, 8GB, 12GB RAM. Variants are available. No SD card, 5G phone, all those things are available. So next, here we are going to talk about its in-depth specs. So this is quite, you know, very important for people who is interested in buying some phones. So for those people, the first thing in this about this phone is, this phone comes with 6.44 inches and it comes with Super AMOLED capacitive touchscreen display. So capacitive touchscreen in the sense, if you have noticed, if you have taken some older phones, older touch phones like maybe 2 or 3 years back, then you might have noticed whenever you try to scroll, your fingerprints might be visible in the screen. That is why, because there a layer on top of your phone. So here in capacitive touchscreen, in the sense that layer and your display has been combined to form a single layer. That's it. So that is the capacitive touchscreen. So this capacitive touchscreen, which is available in the market, comes with two different types. So one is AMOLED display, other thing is LCD display. So in AMOLED display, the high end which is available in the market is Super AMOLED. Whereas in LCD display, the high end model is IPS LCD display. That's it. So whereas if you ask me the difference, if you're going for darker colors or if you're using phones in night times, then AMOLED display is your good choice. Whereas if you're taking photos or videos in morning times, then IPS or LCD display is a good choice. But basically it purely depends on the companies, like manufacturers, which they want to use, depending upon the cost of the phone as well. So this is about its display. Then it comes with 16 million colors. So 16 million colors in the sense, here it comes with 256 shades of red, green and blue. So you'll be having full natural beauties, like natural colors and everything. And in addition to that, it comes with HDR10+. So that is also high dynamic range. So that is also so cool. So the next thing which we are going to talk here in the same thing is basically about its pixel resolution. So this phone comes with a pixel resolution of 1080x2400. So you can go for 1080 videos and 2K videos as well. So those two is also a good choice in this time. This is like what I say about its display. Next we are going to talk about its aspect ratio. So aspect ratio in the sense, as I told earlier, this phone comes with 6.44 inches. It doesn't mean that your screen size is 6.44 inches. So your screen size is given by this aspect ratio. So here it comes with 20:9. So 20:9. So that is your aspect ratio. And in to know more about the phone, you have to look into screen to body ratio. So here it is basically 85%. So in the sense, if you take 100%, 85% is your screen, whereas your 50% is your body. So here the body is also shiny 3D images, bodies and so 3D looks. So that is also so cool in Realme's this new phone launch. So moving forward, next you have to know about its PPI. So that is pixel per inch. So in the sense, if you have taken some photo and if you are trying to zoom it out, you might have noticed that the photo may not be clear and it will be blur. So that is mainly due to this PPI. So in this phone, the PPI density is 409, which is so good, because it is like the top end which is available in the market nowadays. So that is about its PPI. Following this, next we are going to talk about its refresh rate. So since it is a gaming phone, here the refresh rate is 90 Hz, so which is quite okay, because for gaming phones they'll go for 120 Hz or 144 Hz. So here 90 Hz is quite okay when compared to other gaming phones which is available in the market. So refresh rate in the sense, if you have some things, you might have noticed that you have good data or Wi-Fi is so good, but still the phone might be lagging, maybe like 1 millisecond, 1 second and so. That is mainly due to this refresh rate. If you are playing some PUBG top-end games, then you might have noticed there will be a small 1 second or 2 second lag. So this is due to this refresh rate, irrespective of your RAM, processor, other those things. So these are the main things about its display point of view. The next thing which we are going to talk here is basically its processor. So here it comes with Snapdragon 865 SoC chipset. So basically it goes with 5G. So this Snapdragon is combined with 6GB, 8GB or 12GB depending upon your variants, and here it comes with 128GB, 256GB internal, no memory card slot available. So here it comes only with dual SIM, and the beauty of this player phone is here it comes with cooling system to reduce the heat while you're playing some games and so. So here the cooling system is also inbuilt, and this cooling system comes with Hyperboost 3.0 technology. In the sense, the phone will start customizing your needs. In the sense, if depending upon your needs, it will allot memory or graphics or battery and so. So this is about its processor. So following this, next we are going to talk about its camera. So here in rear it comes with Quadcam. So here it comes with 48+8+2+2. So 48 is your primary, whereas 8 is your ultra wide lens with 11 degree. So 11 degree is quite equal to our native type, whereas following 2 megapixel is your depth and 2 is your for macro, whereas your selfie comes with dual punch holes, 16+2. So 16 primary, 2 depth. So all those things about its camera. So the next thing is its battery. So here this phone comes with 4200 mAh battery, which is so good, and here it comes with 65 watts wired super dark fast charging. So the company has given an open statement that you can charge from 0 to 100% in nearly like 53-55 minutes. So that is also so awesome when compared to other charging cables and so, wireless like 30 watts 40 watts and so. So that is good, and this is about its battery. And next thing is, like here it works on all Wi-Fi, Wi-Fi 6, 5, 4, all those stuff. And 3.5mm jack, headphone jack is not available in this phone. Please note it. So there is no jack available here. It comes with dual speakers. So all those other slots, other things, and fingerprint is in display. So those all things are available. So following this, about its price. So it comes around like 30,000 to maybe like 38,000-40,000. So in like what is it? It is officially launched in China only, so we can't say what is the expected price, like what is the official price. So these are like expected price, so we have to wait for the phone to launch in India so that we might know the official price. So that's, it comes with 2 variants 2 colors, all those stuffs are available. So the final thing is, my personal suggestion is for 30,000-35,000, getting these all specs is so good, because camera is good, PPI is good, refresh rate, all those stuffs are good. So if your budget is like 30,000-32,000, please go for this phone. That is so good. Whereas talking for social media and other stuff, this is again a good choice. For social media, please go for like top end, like maybe like 8GB RAM is so good. For gaming, please go for 12. So that is also so good, because all those other brands, everything comes around in the same variant. But what is the thing, all gaming phone comes in the same cost, but variants purely changes. So please look on these all types, like refresh rate, PPI sensors, then go for phone. Please don't look on the brand, or please don't look on the price, and please don't go for it. If you ask me why, for every year all phone brands will launch at least 1 or 2 phones. So in the sense, phones will be updating so fast, so please don't be out of date. Choose the right phone. That is my personal suggestion. So this is the end of this video. So hope so you like this video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. So like this content, I'll just meet you in the next video. So till then, peace from K Square. Bye.